Testing, 1, 2. Testing, 1, 2.
Cool. Already got the 3 Easter eggs.
Ooh.
Yes, this is what we're here for. Boars. Wait. Is that survival? I wasn't paying attention. We'll know when I open the map. Although, saying that, I need to know what the new challenge is for this week, anyhow. So I can figure out what I've got to do during the week to unlock the next legendary weapon. Next legendary Weepon. Still no. Ooh, maybe. I managed to stab myself with some glass at work today. Like a muppet. So that hurts like hell. Well, hurts a bit, not like hell. Okay, this isn't. Game. Crush, kill, destroy, insects, Milex, scorched, wild canines, robots. I can probably. Oh, I have to do all of them. I'll do that. I'll farm. Right. What have I done? Pressed the wrong button. Oh god! I assume it'll be under floor decorations. Oh my god, it's a giant bunny rabbit. Well, it's not giant, but you know what I mean. Yes, and I bought this. Dun-dun-dun-dun. I had enough points. I thought it was going to be one of the small table mounts. No. How does one actually start this? The boars. The burrows. Okay. So, it's a subterranean, whatever. How does one start it? Just says under Harper's Ferry, so I guess that's where we're heading. And yes, I'm going to attempt to do this on my own. I'm fully aware that that may be a mistake, as this dungeon, as far as I'm aware, has been... It's been scaled for two people of level 50 and above. So, I'm level 87, 86 even. So, we'll see how well I get on with it. I'm not gonna lie, I think Bethesda missed the mark slightly with the leveling system in this. If they'd capped it out at level 50, that would have made things a lot more interesting from the point of view of you have to team up to do things because you only have so many perk points between you. Okay, I'll take that. Plan for an auto grenade launcher? Why the hell not? It saves me having to buy it. That's awesome. That is cool. Just a dude in power armor just sprinting on past. I'm over encumbered already. That ain't good. The Burrows. This is awesome. Can't wait to see what it's like. I'm going to be taking this slow, by the way, because I want to read things and figure out what's going on. Hodan. Already it sounds creepy as fuck. Burrows mission brief.
Romeo Squad, this is Defiance. Priority message follows. Intel shows a significant amount of military robotics at the Harper's Ferry pump station. Proceed to the location through the city sewer and conduct recon to identify the source. Report back by 0700. Ad Victorium.
Home is my heart. Waste management quest started. Journey through the burrows and find the source of the robotic activity. Burrows community. Terminal. Friend, welcome to the burrows, the one remaining safe haven in Harper's Ferry where people can live in peace and community. Before the bombs, this place was the old storm sewer where people with nothing could live a real life. And we're trying to keep that spirit alive today. If you're down on your luck, lost everything, or had nothing to begin with, we have a place for you. Follow the main drain tunnel to the central chamber and we'll help you get you placed in one of many neighborhoods spread throughout the tunnels. Please stop by soon. We'd love to get to know you, the Burrows community. Are they going to be cannibals? Also, this place must be falling down. There's a lot of support pillars. Generator. Must be running pumps of some kind. What the hell is that? Gut shroom. Oh, that don't sound particularly appetizing. Where are all the enemies? Maybe it's one of those things of, you can get in and get to the center, but you can never leave again. Where I keep hearing movement. There's something about because my hidden meter keeps moving. Those gunshots can't be other players, right? Because this is an instanced dungeon. Here we go. Contact. Shit. Don't miss. What's that? Oh god, there's a lot. Ignore my terrible shooting. It was like there was a player over there. But that can't be possible. Because this is supposed to be an instant dungeon. I have to say, I like this place so far. It's got the right got the right amount of creepy. Come back so I can shoot you in your head. That'll do nicely. Body, nothing on it. Coffee. Rat steak, fungus soup, rats. There's got to be a player in here. Going that way. Yeah, that's a player with an explosive weapon. Yeah. I would have liked an instanced dungeon where I didn't have to deal with other people. Yes, Bethesda don't want that. So, whatever. That or they messed something up when releasing it, because I'm fairly certain this was supposed to be instanced. Yep, someone's been through here and killed everything. So, that's fun. This is fun, Bethesda. So much fun. When someone else beats you to an area and kills everything. Doc is in Dr. Ken's chem den. All the broken cameras. place seems to have a lot of runarounds. Like it was designed to have a large horde in it. Except that is clearly not the case. Or it's the enemies here are just not up to the level of the players coming through. Because whilst I am on my own, there are other people here. That guy being one of them. And someone's dropping a nuke.
Attention citizens, nuclear strike imminent. Please exit the area at your earliest convenience. Thank you for your cooperation.
A bench would be nice. Bridge control terminal. Work log, bridge malfunction. Entered by Andrew C. Horn, engineer. Description: came to the bridge to look at a faulty line and found a couple of the regulars. Told them to pack up and head out before I called the cops on them for trespassing. I hate to do it, the poor fellas. They're not hurting anyone, and from the look of them, they could use a helping hand, but the law's the law, I suppose.
I need you to listen to me. We can't stay here anymore. Marcus, that son of a bitch. I should have known he'd... The point is, you need to grab your things and leave as soon as possible. Oh, and don't try to leave through Central. One of his goons will just hold you up and give you shit. Alright, I'm headed to Moss Town now. I love you. I hope to see you soon.
Okay, so a guy named Marcus got in charge, and then I guess just started doing whatever the fuck he wanted. So I'm guessing that whatever happened here happened relatively quick. Read to Pete. Okay, Pete, I didn't want to write a note like I'm your damn mum or something, but I'm getting sick of sending out crews to look for the keys you lost. You take something off the shelf, you put it back, understand? Put the keys back in the throne room before we have to beat some common sense into you, Marcus. Okay. Who was Marcus then? Damn it. Sounds like he's someone who got power at some point. journal page. Marcus, that son of a bitch. How could he? Kicking us out of our home? Why? He's giving us all a death sentence. The people he called family. After his speech, a few of the folks said, why don't we fight? We don't. Why don't we do anything at all? It would be foolish. Marcus's group is armed and prepared. They're all strong men, younger than most of us. We wouldn't stand a chance. As much as I hate it, we have to leave. But we're not leaving empty-handed. I've talked it over with some of the elders. Tonight we're going to take back some of the supplies the Burrow Boys took as tribute and leave through the old tunnels. It's dangerous, but Marcus knows that and won't follow us. We can get to the pump station, seal the doors, maybe hack the security system. We can figure it out later. All I know is that if we stay here, we're dead. Okay. So Marcus either took power or was voted in. Sounds more like he took power. And then everyone realized, oh fuck, he's an asshole. Help if I wasn't such a shit shot. Burrow's old tunnel key. I'll remember where that is, but I won't take it yet. Burrow's Boys Terminal. Okay, old tunnel keys. If you need them, they're on my drawer. Just be careful, those tunnels are old as shit. Easy enough to take a fall. The next thing you know, your ghoul food. Remember rule 4, bring a buddy. Weekly upkeep list. Things that need to happen to keep this train on the tracks. Scav runs are required twice a week or more to keep our mouths and guns fed. If it doesn't help, then we go back to eating sewer rats. And that lasts about a week before the guys start taking their frustrations out on each other. The water station needs to be manned at all times. We have water as far as the eye can see, but that shit will kill you if it isn't boiled. Not to mention the taste. Oh, yes. I hate helping my father out down here, but it turned out to be a lifesaver. Learned all sorts of useful stuff about the security. Mainly how easy it is to get into. If we keep them stopped with bullets and not falling apart, they'll keep this place under our control. The usual, take shit off the bodies of morons that wander in here and add it to the pile. Hail to the king! Saving this to commemorate the Burrowed Boys taking over. No more happy-go-lucky community. Shares everything horse shit. No more pioneer scouts helping your fellow man for no damn reason nonsense. No more mooching off the world and no not eating your keep, earning your keep. No poor nor no more pretending that things can ever work the same way they once did. The new world has no place for people not strong enough to take what they need. Good riddance. Now someone was stomping around in power armor. No, it'll be a holotape. He's not entirely wrong. After a nuclear apocalypse, it is a survival situation, and everyone needs to, well, make sure that shit gets done. You gotta bring in food, you gotta bring in supplies, and you gotta bring in ammo. You can't just dilly-dally doing whatever the fuck. And you can't waste resources on those that cannot ever replace those resources. So, for instance, you don't give a dying man food or water. If he is actually dying, you can't waste resources feeding him. Priorities are the children. Children have to be fed, no matter what. Because a child can always earn back what they have used when they're an adult. I also like the little detail of they're constantly fighting the water so it doesn't flood them out of their home. Dr. Ken's terminal. Relocation. Ladies and gents, due to the change in management, thanks to the fine folks in the central chamber, Dr. Ken's Chemden is relocating to Mosstown. If any part of that pink lump in your cranium still works, I'd suggest you do the same. I look forward to continuing your treatment with the same high quality chems at the same low prices. Business hours. I'm here Tuesdays and Thursdays from whenever the hell I wake up to right before sundown when the creepy crawlies come out. Remember the slogan, feeding your addiction with the highest quality chems you can afford. Fucking hell. Menu. Standard fare. Glue and paints for you sniffing needs. Buff out and booze for those seeking a good time on a budget. The hard stuff, Medex Psycho, locked behind the counter, so you're going to have to ask for it. You think I'd keep it on the shelf for you junkies to steal? Exotic tastes, hear me out. If you're looking for the cutting edge of getting high, some of my more adventurous customers told me they got a real rush inhaling the fumes of, well, cow droppings. Oh, Jet. So, if that's your thing, let me know. Boring doctor things. I guess if you have a cold or snot ear or something, I can dig up a disease cure, but it will cost you. Fucking hell. I forgot that Jet was basically just cow shit. Ah, yes. Fallout 2. Or as some would say, back in the good old days. That is both true and false at the same time. Fallout 2 is a great game. But there is something to be said for actually being able to play the game and understand how it works. I think Bethesda missed a bit of a trick there. They could have had a system in place that if you take the fusion core out of this particular generator, it turns off all of the defensive systems that are keeping the hordes of ghouls out. And then this place just gets flooded with ghouls. Be awesome. Another Dead Brotherhood guy. Yep, that's the same as what it said before. That's funny. Also, is this it? This is the entirety of this dungeon. Cool. That's not a dungeon. Hopefully it gets better. Ghoul shouldn't be able to open doors.
Okay.
character is stuck, for fuck's sake. Right. Time to Bethesda my way out of this. Now, power armor works. Oh God! Not what I was expecting. Okay. Work was okay by Earl R. Jester. Work was finally approved to begin renovating here. These tunnels are the oldest part of the storm sewer, stormwater system, and frankly falling apart. Due to potential infrastructure issues, plans have been approved to bypass water flow around these sections. Access will be preserved as they still house pipework that we didn't secure funding to restore. Not to mention, it's currently the only way to access the pump station. What a mess. I'm gonna leave that door closed for the minute. God. All the enemies respawn. I so don't have a lot of 308 left. Let's open this door and see where it goes. after this door. But it was already open. Oh God! I did a thing! Oh boy! Out where all the robots came from. I have to say, I totally did not mean to start that fight when I did. Just kinda happened. Cause I'm an idiot. Deck terminal. Work log, last day. By John L. Welsh, data analyst. Description: 18 years of operating this station, and the bastards come in last week telling us to clean out our things. Everything's going fully automated. I understand the system will find and fix errors quicker, but what I don't understand is where the hell they get off ruining a man's livelihood. I added an executable to the turret defense system they're so proud of. Just a little parting gift before they kick me out. It would be a real shame if something or someone accidentally activated them. Oh shit. Well, I mean, that's one way to, I guess, tell your boss to fuck off. Really stuck it in the man, didn't he? Also, for a high level dungeon, not really. I mean, the Assaultrons were kind of difficult, but all Assaultrons are. Control terminal. Robotic fabricators. J.E. Peck? Peek? Peck? I don't know. Mechanic. Description: completed installation of the robot fabricators. As for now, this station is fully automated. Personally, I think they went overboard with the military grade security, but hey, I'm sure the defense contract secured an 8th yacht for some bigwig asshole at Robco. Probably. Automated status report. Project designation: White Spring Pipeline. Status: ongoing. Power consumption: 420 VAC. Peak range: 90 GPM. Amount dispersed: 600,000 gallons. Okay, that's a lot. Remote door control. Open.
Most of us landed down here in the first place. I just figured I may as well be the one to mean up before somebody else beat me to it. Sorry. I was just thinking how my daddy would be so proud of me. You know, his boy following in his footsteps in waste management. I will see.
Oh, So many holes in this plot. So many things that just make no goddamn sense. Also, not high level at all, really. Totally thought I had this equipped. I want to know if that can be used for anything. I have no idea. It's frozen. That's not good. Okay, it's crashed. It crashed, which is interesting. Also, I don't know if this dungeon's mission is going to be repeatable, but I assume that you can run through the dungeon again, but I don't know if you will be able to get the enemies at the end of it to respawn. Collect all six to complete the Easter egg hunt. Okay, I wasn't an adventure. Do you know what threw me off? I think the pictures, they've swapped them around, I think. timed their loading game. To my camp. So, not the worst DLC that I've ever played of any game ever. Certainly not the best. Has some issues, namely in that it feels a bit lackluster. I don't know if there's much they can do about that. The quests, well, the objective is simple. It's just go from the entrance to the end and then you're done. There's nothing interesting, nothing really to think about. Lore, not a whole lot. Well, not that I found. Doesn't mean there isn't lore. It's just not particularly good. What else? Enemies. Nothing unique, generic, we've seen them all before. Yeah, I'll take that. Hooray, you oversized bird. Lot less ammo now. If you couldn't understand me, I said, got a lot less ammo now. let's head to the White Springs and do a load of trading. Thought I heard a beepy boy. Just wasn't sure where he was.
weapons you need to be tidied up.
Someone says I probably don't need that much black titanium.
Place for creative hands-on learning. And the Wilderness Survival Experience is our most popular program yet. Life is an adventure. Are you up to the challenge? For creative hands-on learning, and the Wilderness Survival Experience is our most popular program yet.
Protect and serve. Protect and serve. Serve. Protect and serve. Protect and serve.
Try not to track blood on the carpet.
Protect and serve. Protect and serve. Protect and serve. Violation of hotel policies may result in detention. Protect and serve and or death.
Hello, I'm Alex. Welcome to the newsstand. It's so nice to have guests again. You have no idea how boring it's been here. What can I get you?
No prescription required. New patient detected. Commencing introduction. We have Kim's.
Good morning. Sorry, we haven't had a new movie here in ages.
Good morning, sir.
Guest security is our priority.
That's the second legendary light machine gun I've seen. Still not worth it.
Thank you.
Right. I'm going to finish up here for the evening. I will probably be playing later, but that'll just be grinding in survival. So, yeah. I will see you in the next part. So, tune in next time. Bye.
Bye.